forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. Pancreas swelling collapse, the record low 1,327 on Monday on Sunday over the funding of recently accounted UK tax cuts, which come on top of hawk energy subsidies. But the pound recovered from the low to $1,782 on Tuesday, up 84% after Bank of England said late on Monday it would not hesitate to change interest rates and was monitoring markets very closely. Bank of England chief economist Hugh Peel said on Thursday that both is likely to deliver a significant policy response to last week's announcement of tax cut by Finance Minister Kwasi Kwarteng, but is called wait until the ISNEC meeting in November before making its move. The pound has suffered a build-up in negative sentiment, which we believe has room to unwind, said crisis testmaker, multi-asset fund manager at Legal and General Investment Management, adding that the asset manager was taking a moderate positive view on sterling versus the euro. LGIM would likely add to its position on any further fall in the pound, as this would only make support from the government or Bank of England more likely. This market added, the yield on 5-year gilt rose as much as 100 basis points in two trading days, but was down 74% in mid-day trading Thursday. Spillover from Britain kept other assets on edge. Pound selling in Japan posted yield up the Bank of Japan selling and prompted more unscheduled buying from the central bank in response. The German 10-year bond yield breathing it a new nearly 11-year hike of 2,142% before easing. 10-year U.S. bond yield gained 47 basis points to 3,925% from the U.S. close after reaching a hike on Monday of 3,933%. The MSCI World Equity Index gained nearly 1% after hitting its lowest since November 2020 on Monday. European stock against 3%. MSCI broke the index of Asia shares outside Japan hit a fresh 2-year low before gaining 3%. Japan Nikkei was up 5%. The dollar index was flat on Thursday. After touching $114.58 on Monday, its strongest since May 2002, the euro was up about 1% after hitting a 20-year low a day ago. Oil rallied after peaking to 9-month lows in the previous session, helped by supply curbs in the U.S. Gulf of Mexico ahead of Hurricane Ian and by a slight softening in the U.S. dollar. U.S. crude rose 15% to $78.13 per barrel, and Brent was at $86.82, up 3.28% on the day. That and Brent gas prices rose on news that the Nord Stream gas pipeline from Russia to Europe had suffered damage, raising concerns over the security of the bloc energy inventories and making a sweet assumption in flow through the pipeline even less likely. Got which hit a 2-year low on Monday, rose around 1% to $1,637 an ounce. Bitcoin broke above $20,000 for the first time in about a week as cryptocurrencies bounced along with other sensitive assets. Share in Italy outperformed European Press on Monday after the right-wing coalition led by Giorgia Meloni overwhelmingly won the national election, while Brussels elsewhere fell amid risk aversion following central bank tightening. The Europe with stock 600 index fell of 4%, closing near December 2020 lows following a sharp sell off last week when data showing a downturn in economic activity in the region and tightening by several global central banks deepened fear of a recession. Okay, maybe that's all from me. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe.